Welcome to another episode of SpaceX in the News. My name's Kevin, and today we're just going to take a really brief look at the latest Starship developments. Our main focus will be commercial crew and the other day's press conference that Elon Musk and Jim Bridenstine put on. Then we'll learn a fascinating history lesson as to why an upcoming Falcon 9 mission will launch to a polar orbit from the Cape instead of Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. Then we'll finish with today's honorable mention. Let's get into it. So again, not a whole lot to discuss today concerning Starship updates, but that doesn't mean that nothing is happening at the Boca Chica and Coco sites. The launch pad for the Mark 1 prototype is still receiving major upgrades in preparation for the 20-kilometer flight that should take place within a month, and Pad 39A is undergoing its own upgrades for future Starship launches. Furthermore, the Mark 2 prototype that will utilize the launch pad has recently received external pipage. The next Starship update Elon puts on will include more information concerning the plan for point-to-point transit on Earth. This week, NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine and SpaceX CEO Elon Musk put on a press conference at SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California, with the sole intent to promote the commercial crew program. Just prior to the event, Jim was given a tour of the facilities, and NASA took some pretty nifty pics, including an image of the Crew Dragon capsule that will be the first to take American astronauts to space early next year. Those two astronauts, Bob and Doug, were in attendance as well. And despite NASA's Flintstones quality stream, CNBC managed to do us a solid with what they captured. So here's just a quick little run through of all the interesting moments from the media briefing. First, the status of Crew Dragon and what's to come.
We have a static fire that is going to be happening in short order. We have a high altitude abort test that will be happening in short order. We talked even today that we could see as many as 10 drop tests between now and the end of the year.
But we'll have the first successful Mach 3 drop test within, a week or two. And then there'll be a steady cadence of tests thereafter.
Second, Elon commented on the Crew Dragon Demo 1 capsule that exploded last April.
And to be totally frank, if there hasn't been some hardware that blew up on the test stand, I don't think you tested it hard enough. That's the reality. Yeah, you've got to push the envelope, find out where the outer issues are, and then address all the corner cases.
Jim said that the explosion of the Demo 1 capsule gave him confidence in Elon Musk and SpaceX because the very cause of the explosion, the propellant, was the very thing that Elon said he was worried about when Jim became administrator.
Elon Musk said to me, he said, that's the biggest concern, that's what we need to be worried about. And I will tell you, if we look at the catastrophic failure that happened back in April, he was right. And that gives me confidence, and that is why we text.
Doug and Bob were appreciative of SpaceX's transparency concerning the explosion, as we all are.
Any of these failures as they go forward, giving us insight and sharing that understanding as we go forward has been a part of what makes me so comfortable with this team kind of going forward. And I just really appreciate how much insight we've been able to have, how quickly we've been able to have it in each of these cases.
We all know I love parachutes, so imagine my excitement when they started talking about the new Mark 3 design.
The biggest difference between the Mark 2 and the Mark 3 is going to much stronger lines in the parachute. So going from essentially nylon to xylon. The strength of the lines is about 3 times that of nylon. And then there are some changes to the stitching pattern where the lines connect to the canopy. You've got a stress concentration. And so you want to have just exactly the lines.
Jim was asked about William Gerstenmaier's permanent replacement for Associate Administrator for Human Exploration and Operations.
We opened the aperture very wide initially. We have started narrowing it down, but we are not ready to announce who that person is. But I will tell you that announcement is not months away, it's weeks away. And that's a day that we're all looking forward to.
And finally, Jim wanted to clarify his position and NASA's position on Starship.
I want people to make no mistake. That NASA has an interest in seeing Starship be successful. We have been a partner on Starship, a non-exchange of funds kind of partner, when it comes to aerodynamics and when it comes to testing and test facilities.
Crew Dragon is currently expected to launch for its Demo 2 mission with Bob and Doug on board in the first quarter of 2020. NASA has been training a lot lately for this upcoming mission to the International Space Station, and a view from the Demo 1 capsule during liftoff was recently shared as well. The Falcon 9 rocket for the Argentinian space agency's SAWACOM Earth Observation Satellite will no longer lift off from Vandenberg Air Force Base, but instead will move to the Cape for its launch no earlier than February 2020. While I'm not sure why, it could be due to California's known hostility towards Vandenberg's commercial launch manifest. But what makes this move so surprising is that this particular satellite will be placed into a polar orbit, and polar trajectories haven't launched from Florida in decades. See, in 1960, tensions were peaking between the US and Cuba during the Cold War. In fact, just a year later, the Bay of Pigs invasion would take place. But that November, a Thor-able star launch vehicle attempted to place a military spy satellite in a polar orbit from Cape Canaveral. Unfortunately, the booster malfunctioned and caused a slight diversion in the flight path. The rocket was manually detonated as standard protocol dictates, but an unlucky Cuban cow was prematurely slaughtered when it caught a piece of falling debris. And you can imagine the following drama that ensued between the two nations during such a delicate time in history. And so the US decided to end polar orbits from the Cape until now. And now it's time for today's honorable mention. All right, we're back with yet another segment of Richard Branson's Virgin Company. Only this time we'll be discussing Virgin Orbit and their mission to be the first private company to send CubeSats to Mars as early as 2022. Despite the fact these Virgins haven't yet penetrated low Earth orbit. Formed in 2017 as a spin-off of Virgin Galactic, Virgin Orbit uses the familiar method of launching a rocket, known as Launcher One, like a missile from the bottom of a Boeing 747, named Cosmic Girl. Virgin prides themselves on launching rockets differently than most other space agencies, and this new Martian endeavor was reportedly inspired by NASA's InSight mission, which, if you remember, successfully used CubeSats to relay the descent status of the InSight lander onto the surface of Mars in 2018. Virgin Orbit will be tag-teaming this particular mission with Poland-based satellite company Sat Revolution. Well, that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for tuning in, and until the next one, Godspeed. These SpaceX in the News episodes are made possible by the generous donations of my Patreon members. And if you would like to see even more SpaceXcentric content, consider becoming a Patreon yourself. Even a dollar a month will get you access to exclusive videos not available here on YouTube. There's a link in the description.
And God bless, my friend.